this, the second volume of Trains Remembered, we bring you a wide selection of trains from the past. From the camera of Mr. Alan Willmott, the Marlow branch of the Great Western, they had to get in somewhere. After this, Mr. Willmott visited Weymouth and managed to catch the one boat train of the day. This quaint train ride is still very much happening today, although a diesel class 33 is now used. Another branch filmed by Mr. Willmott was this one, to Newport Pagnall. Mr. Ralph Cooper spent many happy hours here in 1959, capturing the smoky, grimy steam age. These pictures bring back many memories of grising and spotting at the platform ends. At Hatfield, a beautifully restored J52 is about for inspections. It finished up giving brake van rides. Nearby, a good spot for watching expresses go by. Some were in terrible condition. Back at King's Cross, a few A3s were about. suburban services were in the hands of the immensely successful N2s. Up and down the two steep tunnels each side of the main station, they hauled trains from Moorgate to towns in Hertfordshire and Middlesex. Today there was trouble with the signalling. Trains were held up and eventually worked through manually. This suburban train came to a stop just outside the station. The fireman of a waiting B1 calls up the box to find out what's happening. The fireman, now satisfied, goes off to his B1. And the N2 restarts its train. The B1 now has a clear road ahead. Mr. Cooper's camera captures a long-gone steam age. An N2 is going to the coaling stage. They use this overhead machine then. Meanwhile, a trip through grimy Bell Isle and Copenhagen fields to find hand-operated signalling still in use. Mr. Cooper proved you don't have to stop filming at dusk. A rare J35 trundles into the platform at Hitchin. And eventually, another turns up. Back at King's Cross, a J50 has some vintage vehicles in tow. The third one is a six-wheeled Midland and Great Northern milk van. In the Hadley Wood area, the main line was being widened. It's a nice place to watch trains go by. But big changes are around the corner. This is the Master Cutler from Sheffield. The last week of the N2s at New Barnet. The new one, English Electric's Deltic, on loan to BR for evaluation purposes. It was soon put to work on the main expresses. After meeting the crew and a couple of inspectors, we're getting a lift to Doncaster. The driver took it a bit easier around the reverse curves at the River Ouse. Now approaching a very steamy Peterborough. Crew, watch out for water troughs, as the Deltic uses water for its train heating boiler. The last somersault signal at Claypole. Now approaching the flat crossing at Redford. More water troughs ahead. This time some is taken on. journey's end and we say goodbye to the crew. Holborn Viaduct station on the southern region. Underneath these platforms is another station, Snow Hill, and trains used to run down this slope, entering a tunnel. It hasn't seen a passenger train stop here since 1916. Freight trains used the route until the early 70s. Now BR is to spend £50 million on new track and trains for through running again from the Midlands. At the north end of the tunnel, Midland Region trains run to King's Cross and beyond. The line will be reconnected to them. The tunnel from Farringdon Station. A bridge at the other end of the platform. And a flashback to the last steam freight train to use the route. Roberts Bridge on the main line to Hastings, and the now disappearing DEMUs arriving. Also a bullet Q1. This was the start of the Kent and East Sussex Railway. This old film was taken on 9.5mm by Mr. Robin Doust, and it's worth using because of its rare footage. This terrier stands by a rare shot of Rolvenden Shed, soon to be pulled down by BR. The passenger service ceased in 1954. But a steam-hauled goods train continued until 1961. A little diesel shunter came on duty. Soon the specials arrived. Locals wave goodbye to what seems like the last train on the line. A loco at each end, the Southeastern. Once the line closed, odd vehicles appeared. Old steam engines. And this took to the tracks. The preservationists had arrived. After many years of hard work, money and enthusiasm, the line was declared ready for reopening to the public. In 1974, the ceremony took place. Mike Burgess reports.
At last, the official reopening. It was June the 1st, 1974. Up from Rolvenden came the motive power for the day. Two terriers and Arthur, our spare loco, who had recently been completely overhauled and were run up and down the sidings for photo fodder. Colnbrook town band gave a festive air to the occasion as number 10 received a final polish. Celebrities included the Mayor, Mr. Peter Davis, Mr. Benj Abbott, and the MP for Ashford, Mr. William Deeves, who was to give the main speech and then reopen the line. Slowly, she steams forward for the opening ceremony. The traditional bottle of champagne across the buffer beam.
As any test of fortune, one who may travel on her.
The christening is over, and our guests climb aboard for the opening run down the line. We come to the end of 13 years of struggle. Our story started in 1961 when a bunch of dedicated youngsters saved the line from the scrapyard. We've come through all the troubles you can name. Inquiries, discussions, objections, disasters, inspections, and lack of finance. The faithful few have survived all this and more. Today, the farmer's line has been reborn, and the Rother Valley echoes again with the sound of steam.
A steam train come to the country, see what you'll see. People polishing tank locomotives, people like you and me. People stoking boilers and people tapping wheels. There's steam building up in the country, in the Kent and Sussex fields. Just for history, it isn't just for fun. It's just to show the whole known world how a railway should be run.
Another line to reopen was a section of the once extensive Isle of Man railways. The whole system had closed down for the winter and somehow didn't reopen the following spring. So after much reorganisation and finance, the section from Douglas to Peel was carrying passengers again.
Thank you.
Our cameras visited the line again in 1971 and examined the line and the other remains. The line on the right leads away to the other parts of the island railways. What a sad sight this all is. Will it ever be restored? A change of scene now, just outside London. At the end of the central line, in pleasant country surroundings, is the Ongar section. With little passenger numbers and operating only in peak hours, it's in great danger of closing. A branch of the Great Eastern Railway Company, it was steam-hauled until London Transport took it over. Today, tube trains run into North Weald, although for how long is anybody's guess. The passing loop was taken out many years ago when traffic failed to materialise. These scenes were filmed in 1980. Trains used to stop at Blakehall then. They don't now. Today the train trundles into Ongar station and the few passengers head for the High Street. Another London Transport steam branch filmed by Mr. Willmott in the 1960s on the Metropolitan line, the Chesham branch. It has worked as a shuttle for most of its life. Steam traction ended in 1960. Some of the coaches went to the Bluebell Railway. Thank you.
Oh, it hasn't all come over the back yet.
Ken Atwood visited Kingmore Depot in 1966. This was very near Carlisle, and there were quite a few steam locomotives around for him to film. Thank you. Oliver Cromwell was here today. It's BR's 15 guinea special. Oliver Cromwell then ran light to Bressingham Steam Centre to retire from active service. Now the Woodhead route. The LNER planned to electrify the Manchester-Wath-Sheffield line before the last war. The work was finally finished afterwards. These are the EM1 Bobo type. They were filmed by Mr. Sean Davis in 1965. A second type, the EM2, was a cocoa locomotive. After some years' service, some of them went to Holland in 1968. This route was closed eventually. The locomotives, designed by Sir Nigel Gresley, out of date in this high-speed AC electric traction age. In June 1986, the EM2s ended their days with the Dutch Railways. We filmed one of the last specials.
Thank you.
On the Keighley-Worth Valley Railway, a snowplough is being fitted to today's loco. Corfe Castle in Dorset, back in time to the Swanage Railway. M7s are still in use. In 1969, online cameras visited the line. Now there are diesel-electric trains here. Finally, on the main line from Marylebone in March 1986, we bring you some of the steam trains running to Stratford this year. Here's 4472, the Flying Scotsman. The next Sunday, a return visit by Sir Nigel Gresley,